get your canvas and brushes ready because we have our special artist here today. Let me introduce you to Karin Holmström. Welcome.
Thank you, Elin. Thank you. Hi, everyone. I'm so happy to be here. I'm Karin Holmström, and I call myself a life explorer in color. I always had the art as a hobby, always since I was a child. It's been in periods. And now it is 13 years ago, and we got our first child. And that was also the same time as my father got sick in cancer, and not long after he unfortunately passed away. And I really didn't know where to put all my emotions. It was really, really hard to be a mother and to know that her grandfather wouldn't be there. And so I was in a dark hole, and all these emotions. And the only place where I really could feel more at ease was when I took out the painting, when I took out the canvas, and I just went in to paint again. And that was like time and space just disappeared, and I went into the total flow. And I felt that this, I need this more. And I started to take painting classes again. So every Monday I went away for a couple of hours and just to paint. And the more I did, I just loved it, and the more I wanted to be in it. And things started to happen. I could really feel that it evolved on the canvas more and more and more. So let's start to take out the paint. And I will tell you that I will, my aim for tonight is to fill this canvas with paint. It is to put on a lot of colors and just go with the flow, make it have fun. I'm not going to try, okay, this must be a masterpiece, because that really blocks. There's been so many times when I just like, it blocks if you go too much into the performance. So the art, it comes from within, and I will really try to inspire you to also find that source within you. So just grab the colors that you like and start moving, and don't think about what you are doing actually. You should leave your head somewhere else and just go with your body. That is my advice. And I always start with the foundation, to just ground myself, really. Take a few breaths, just breathe and try to relax and have fun. And I also love to have music in the background as we have here. Mm-hmm. So I start with just, I will actually start taking on my, I will have this because I will use my hands, and I don't want to destroy this lovely garment. So I have the gloves on. I just take out a lot of colors, and I use the prime colors, which is yellow, blue, red. Yeah, what will this be? You never know. And that is what is so exciting, that you don't know where the journey will end. I start somewhere, and when I paint in so many layers. So it doesn't really matter what happens in this first layer. And I would just go and have fun, play with it. So the first stage is the playing phase, the playing. And you can grab whatever you have at home. I love to paint with this painting knives and big brushes. The bigger the better. And of course you have to have water also. So always put your things in water and take away also the paint before. But you can use whatever, roller, like for making the windows. So many things that you can, or use a credit card, or I love to use this, and it's actually so beautiful if you see it. Sometimes, you know, the palette is like an art in itself. Seal it. Okay, I start with this rubber scrape thing, and that is a really good tool to just take out the paint on the canvas. I love when it does like this, mixed. And I often start a little darker, and then the next layer, because it has to dry for a couple of hours, or I use, well, at least a day, I usually let the painting dry before I do the next layer, especially in the first phase where it can be really like wet color. Inspiration comes from so many things. I would say I worked also a lot of years in the fashion industry and with a lot of strong women. And it's been a journey for me to explore my inner power and to dare to be a full-time artist and to take that step. I also write about it in my book, Fearless, The Art of Living Creatively. There where I share a lot about where my inspiration comes from. But it is from animals, it is from life, it is from within, a lot of my own emotions and experiences. So it can come out the female characters with a lot of power words or the animals, or it's more abstract. So, and nature, I often take walks in the forest, and I'm also inspired by nature. Here I can see like the ocean. And as I say, I like to start with darker colors, and then my next layers I do lighter, and I can highlight and I can see things that I then bring out. So one very important thing is also to step aside a little bit. Use a lot of this is a good tool, just to have a piece of plastic, and you can really draw out the paint. It can give really cool effects. So in the end, maybe just some of this that you see in the painting, but then you know that, because every brush stroke or every color matters. In the end, every layer, everything do matters, even though you will not see all this. Well, for me, I don't want a painting to be too perfect. I don't strive for perfect. When it is, then I can destroy it a little bit. The best thing also is to take breaks, to really step aside from the painting for a while, do something totally different. So to pause, I usually have like 3 or 4 paintings going on at the same time. And I have a few paintings that have been with me in the studio for 2 years, and it still isn't ready. So it is different, and sometimes it can go really quick. But to work with not having it too perfect, that is also a journey to work with yourself a lot. So I would say the biggest benefit of being a full-time artist and for these 5 years is the inner journey. It's been really evolving because every painting would teach me something in my process and in life. And and I believe that everyone, all of us, are creative beings. We have so much in us. And then maybe not everyone likes to paint, but we have so much creativity. And we are so much more. Some plastic, if you have. Some bubble. And that makes also some fun. So use whatever. Just play with it. Just have fun. Put on the music and dance and enjoy. I think we need to just enjoy more, especially now. And this, why not put in some words here? I think I want Odd Molly to be in this painting. But my goal is to fill the canvas and see what happens. It's so many paintings that they were done and I have continued on it. But that I see it as a learning. Every painting is a learning process and a learning step. So you have to go through those things as well, I think, to evolve and to... To stop, to pause, to wait a little bit, to relax, to breathe. It's really good if I've been away for a couple of days and then come back to my studio. Then I can see some totally new things. Just to do some things under is also... It's really cool then that to have some structure in the painting. So... Don't be afraid at this stage. Just add on. I go a little bit crazy here, just to show you. This you can use. And actually we can have... Put on some tape. Yeah, dance with me. This is a great tool. And don't forget, sometimes just see it on the other, just make it upside down. One of my favorite paintings, it can be open in the process. Let it follow and it can change a lot during the process. Like in life. And some more. Because I think that this one is can rest. I love this face when it's just to go with the flow.